common fate. Common fate is basically that objects that move together are perceived as grouped or related. Now, over the summer, I actually found a very nice animated GIF that showed this, and when I went to check this morning, it wasn't there anymore. So I will try to look for another example. Here's the basic idea, and then we're going to look at it in an interface. You'll be able to see it in an interface a little bit better. If you have these three circles moving in one direction, and those two circles moving in another direction, you're going to interpret it as being two groups. Why? Because they have a common fate. They are moving together. Now, that's pretty easy to visualize, right? Now, there's a question of, all right, how do you use this in design? Because that's actually the harder question for a lot of people. Well, where you see this a lot is with menus, particularly drop-down menus that kind of slide down. And we'll look at one really, you know, we'll look at a live one in a minute. All right, and also in tooltips. You remember what tooltips are, right? What happens with tooltips? You want to know what something is? You hover, right, and something pops up. Let's go over to, actually, I can just show you here. Let me see, I can't remember, do these have, no, this one doesn't have drop-downs anymore. All right, so here we go. So here we have a drop-down menu. Now, it only happens to be two. Usually, it's easier to see if you have multiple ones. The basic idea is that when those move together, we automatically group them together. So if you look at this, here we have automatic, primary monitor, and down here we have monitors. Now, how many of you grouped these together and did not put monitors down here with the rest of this group? Everyone, I hope. So anyone who didn't do that? Okay, no answer. I'm getting lots of no answers. So here's the idea. Because these move together, we have a tendency to interpret them together. Now, let's see if we can get a tooltip up here. So here we have our tooltip. It's a little long. Now, when I hover over that and the tooltip appeared, what did you notice? The tooltip appeared. Right? It is a movement. It caught your attention. And so if I go over here, what do you associate that tooltip with?
Description.
With the start recording. What is it? Start recording from beginning. Now, are you associating with it with play navigations? No. Are you associating it with use timings? Keeps going away on me. Now, if you look, let's see if we can get it to come up here. So if you look at things like proximity, is that going to tell you which it goes to? What do you think? If you look at, I wish I could reach. If you look at the bottom of show and the bottom of show media controls, between that and the tooltip, is there a difference in terms of proximity? There's not. So not so much with proximity. But because we have associated this movement, that's considered common fate in an interface. All right, so this drops down. We have a tendency to group these together because they are moving together. Now, common fate, you can also use to take things that are very similar to each other and have us automatically categorize them. Unfortunately, I don't know where this live web page is, but this is from your Johnson book. This was basically a photographer where she had a lot of her work, some very beautiful images of people, and then she had beautiful images of herself. And what she found was that people were having difficulty distinguishing between which were pictures of her and which were pictures of her work. So on this web page, one of the things that they did was this: they actually had all of these moving together. Because when you would go to the web page, you actually would kind of rotate into place all together. And when that happened, people immediately understood, without having to be told actually, that that was her work. And it was separate from images of her. So you can use these things artistically in ways that help users understand something about your interface. So here's the real fun part. In reality, when you are looking at interfaces, you're not just going to find one, and very often not even just two, of these Gestalt laws. You're going to find multiple Gestalt laws, because really, we tend to put them all together. Right, we'll use similarity and proximity. It may be similarity and proximity in the same element, or maybe similarity and proximity in different elements. There's figure ground. Do you guys see figure ground here? So again, here if you look at this, we see a lot of different elements of Gestalt theory. So here's my little test. I want you to tell me what you see and point out where you see it. A little more difficult when you have an actual interface and there's so much going on there, right? The question is, I want you to look at this interface and tell me where you see, which Gestalt laws you see and where you see them.
Proximity.
Where do you see proximity?
The bar on the left and all the images. All the options.
This?
Yeah.
Yep, you definitely see proximity there. Because these are all tools. They're similar. They're put together. It's next to the image. Sorry, what?
Continuity.
Tell me where you see continuity.
The second square.
The second
square.
The white square in. I'm seeing lots of white squares.
The foreground.
Oh, the windows. Oh, so this one.
And the desktop.
That is correct. So we assume that this menu continues.
And the desktop
continues. Closure. Tell me where you see closure. Wait, it looks what?
The beginning of the mountain is the top of the bottom. I don't know.
Are you talking about?
Yeah, it's like a waterfall turns into a river.
Yeah.
Oh, you're talking about the image.
Yeah, the image.
Yes, you're right, because when we look at the image, we don't interpret the waterfall as suddenly stopping there. All right, what else? Figure ground?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're kind of like, yeah, but that was obvious. It can't be too obvious if this is an exam question.
Did you say that symmetry, because we organize like the panel as one thing, image as another, and everything, we organize it together?
Right, so you can say there's symmetry. It is organized very well. If you look at even this, you know, this tool palette, there's a lot of symmetry in there. It makes it very easy for us to interpret what that's for, and our eye moves through it very easily and quickly. Makes it a lot easier. Okay, I'm going to take one more thing. Anything else? It can be something we mentioned just in a different element, too. Anything? Oh, you're talking about that. So we assume that continues.
And the bar in the bottom.
And the bar on the bottom also, we assume that continues. So if you look at this, combining it all, it can make things a lot easier to understand, but boy, it can get pretty complex. But think about it this way. What we're doing is we're taking a complex situation, a complex interface, and using the Gestalt laws to try to help simplify and make it easier for us to understand and to be able to interpret quicker. It reduces our cognitive load. Make sense?